Hari ini kita mau buat welcome dinner untuk Sophia Rogan. Sophia Rogan, kita bakal dinner ketemu sama PL-PL tercinta. Sini pembuat rambutnya Ayu Ting Ting, namanya Krisna Fahrezi. Aku daulat untuk bikin rambutnya Sophia Rogan. Karena waktunya mepet, dia senewan stres, akhirnya jambul nggak bisa on. Akhirnya Teja Sarialah yang hari ini dapat poin.
Check point.
Benar. Ini Teja Sarial. Crown yuk.
Are you ready for tonight? Let's go!
Saya mengundang teman-teman Portal Pageant. Kenapa? Karena kalianlah bisa mewakili teman-teman pageant lovers lainnya. I just wanna say thank you for all of you. Because what? Because your guys work very hard to vote and to present Aura waktu Aura di Miss Grand International. Tepuk tangan. Semalam official Aura sudah turun tahta, sudah dilanjutkan oleh penerusnya, dan Aura juga tidak pernah lupa berterima kasih kepada teman-teman pageant lovers semuanya. So what do you wanna say for pageant lovers Indonesia?
Wow, you are, thank you so much for being here for our Miss Grand also, and I really want to say thank you to all of you who really support me and mau vote Rihanna. It really means a lot for me. Thank you so much, and all the fans around the world, especially Indonesia, you're all amazing, and I'm forever in love with you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, dan sesuai dengan janji saya akan mengundang queen saya yang baru. Mungkin kita bisa bangkit berdiri semuanya. So, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present my new queen, Sophia Rogan.
Mumpung
pageant lovers here, so kita kenalan ya.
Okay.
Because pageant lovers will introduce herself.
And yeah, them.
Oh my god.
Oh yeah, himself. Okay,
sorry.
Yeah.
Stay there.
Okay, my name is Ocha. I'm from Sulawesi Barat.
Kamu portal pageantnya apa?
Sa Sulawesi Barat.
Sa Sulawesi Barat.
Oh, okay. Hi, nice to meet you.
Hello, my name is Aditya Yasmin. I'm from Indonesia.
Ya, Aditya Yasmin? Oh, wow. Ini Yasmin ya. From?
Indonesia.
Indonesia, okay. Remember ya?
Yes.
Hi, Sophie. Enjoy your rain. So I'm Brian Abigail from Indonesian Pageants too.
Oh,
nice to see you.
Hi, nice
you
to see
you.
You
look gorgeous.
Thank you so much.
Hi, Sophie. Good evening. My name is Adit. I'm from pageantempire.com.
Wow. Hi.
Nice to see you.
Hi.
And we're in Sambong. Pageant Empire. Thank you.
Hello, Sophia. Hello, Aigun. My name is Egi. I'm from the Maidong. Thank you.
Hi Sophie, hi Kai Gun, selamat malam semuanya. My name is Surya and I'm from Dewi Damu.
Halo Sophie, halo Kai Gun, salam kenal Sophie. Saya Hendri Andreas dari Dewi Damu.
Hi Sophie, hi Kai Gun. Saya Amrita Budiman dari Pageant Count Warriors.
Sorry Kai Gun, Sophia, saya Somandi Wijaya dari Pageant Count Warriors.
Good night, Sophia.
Good
evening, maybe ya. Perkenalkan, Bunda Latinas.
Sophia, Kang Kai Gun, saya Dimas dari Garuda Legends.
Halo Kai Gun, halo Sophia, saya Richard dari Garuda Legends.
Halo Miss Sophia, Kai Gun, aku Bayi Setiawan dari Nisos Indonesia.
Hai semuanya, Kai Gun. I'm the last but not least. I'm Ariana Utianas from Nisos Indonesia.
Thank you so much.
Okay. So, thank you all for being here. I'm looking forward to getting to know each and every one of you individually, because I know some of you have just discovered me yesterday, but some of you have been following me for years. So, I'm so glad you guys can be here, and I can't wait to chat with you all. Thank you guys.
Thank you. Sofia atau mau tanya something sama Aura, sama Bella, or sama Nadia juga, kita kasih tepuk tangan dulu Nadia. Nadia represent Indonesia di ajang Miss Face of Humanity. Yes, jadi berangkat bulan Oktober, Nadia mungkin satu-satunya perwakilan Indonesia yang ikut beauty pageant rambutnya pendek. Ya, kita coba keuntungan Cina. Tambah cantik gak?
Cantik.
Pastinya ya. Oke. Okay. Kemarin ada PLL bilang gini, Sophie udah cantik, lalala, gak usah dia papain, mereka semua terlambat. Oke, okay. Okay. We just relax, put your mic here, if there's somebody giving you a question, you can answer.
Hello Sophie. First of all, congratulations. Sophia. Hello Sophia. First of all, congratulations for your crowning as Miss Grand Indonesia. I just wish you the very best luck for your competition. Well, my question is, most of us already know that, like you already established your career as a model. And then the question is, why? How could you end up as a beauty queen right now? Okay. Maybe you can say and tell the story behind it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, so it's quite interesting. It's probably not like very ordinary, but so I had just graduated high school in Bali. I was living in Bali for 2 years, and I already met Kai Ivan in 2018 at Miss Grand, actually, when Nadia Purwoko won. And so we met there. And then after a few years, you know, I was living in Bali, and then Kak Ivan reached out to my mom, actually, because Aura and I are still friends. We've been friends since I was like 15. So Aura told Kak Ivan about me, and yeah, he reached out to my mom, and he just asked my mom, like, do you think Sophie is interested in this? And my mom was like, you should ask her. So he asked me, and at first I was like really shocked, you know, because pageantry is not really something that I ever envisioned myself getting into, because I've never really had friends do it besides from Aura. So yeah, I was quite shocked, but then after a little bit of thinking, you know, I realized how this is such an amazing opportunity. How can I turn this down, you know? And it's only 1 year, maybe even less, you know? But yeah, I figured that I would do this and give it my all and see what doors it can open for me. So yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Good luck for that.
Thank you.
And what I want to say also, Mike Katilin speaking through us. And I want to say also that Sophie ini punya gift lain. She can sing very well. Dan dalam waktu dekat ini juga Sophie untuk mengisi waktu-waktunya training, Sophie akan buat satu single yang rencananya akan dibuat lagunya oleh salah satu musisi di Indonesia. Kenapa? Why I want to make a single for you? Because singing is also your passion. I don't want you to be fully stressed for the preparation. I want you to like relax, and also, I mean, like, you know, your passion is jalan bareng, you know. Yeah. And it's quite crazy, yeah. Work together, no problems. That man. Yeah. Because Miss Grand International, Miss Grand Indonesia, kita lebih ke entertainment business. So, aku mau queen aku semuanya bisa bekerja di dunia entertainment. Apakah presenting, ataukah film, or many more. Kayak Bella, Bella sudah beberapa kali menjadi hosting televisi. Aura juga seperti itu. Tapi saya juga mau kasih kejutan lagi. Next week ada kabar yang sangat menggemparkan dari Aura dan juga Sophia.
Wow.
Aura sama Sofia akan merepresent satu tokoh, dua tokoh yang ada di film Disney. Tunggu aja, akan saya umumin tanggal 25. So it's gonna be a big news for Sofia and Aura. We had a photo shoot and video a couple days ago. Dan tadi aku udah press conference bareng sama teman-teman media. Mungkin kalau ada yang lihat postingan aku barusan, aku posting di background film apa. Jadi aku akan menjadi satu-satunya desainer Indonesia yang mendesainkan baju untuk film tersebut. Dan aku punya dua queen yang bisa merepresent karakter dari film itu. Jadi tunggu aja tanggal 25. Dan aku juga dapat jatah video, nonton bareng. Jadi kalau misalnya nanti bisa Ayah, Dardo, koordinasi, teman-teman PL bisa nonton bareng lagi sama queen kalau ada yang mau. Ya, yeah? Okay. Another question, please.
Okay, thank you. I'm sorry, I'm not that fluent in English.
That's totally
fine. I was trying to speak Indonesian. So, selamat sekali pertama-tama untuk gelar barunya. Seperti yang kita tahu, seorang Aura Charisma telah memberikan standar yang tinggi untuk perwakilan Indonesia, pastinya dengan keluar biasaannya dia, dengan karakternya yang kuat, strong, dengan karakter yang benar-benar tidak gembar-gembor, tetapi tiba-tiba yang menusuk sanubari kita lah sebagai pageant lovers. Itu kekuatan yang saya lihat dari seorang Aura Charisma. So, apa yang mau seorang Sofia tunjukkan kepada kami untuk menjadi kekuatan seorang Sofia, untuk meyakinkan kami sebagai seorang pageant lovers agar mendukung dan memberikan dukungan kami sepenuhnya kepada Sofia. Please.
Okay, well, first of all, I totally agree with you about what you said about Aura.
Thank you so much.
She has set the bar so high. She has set the bar so high. Honestly, it makes me nervous that I'm after her. Okay. But you know, since I got into this, I know that pageantry sometimes can be quite challenging. And for me, the number one thing is to stay authentic to myself. Because if I win, I believe that I will win because I am a genuine person and I would deserve it, you know? If that is my path in life, then that is what the universe has planned for me. And yeah, I try to stay true to my heart as much as I can, and I really want to bring this crown back for Indonesia because, yes, because all of the Indonesian pageant lovers and fans are just unbelievable, you know? I've only been crowned yesterday and I'm just like overwhelmed with support, so I feel like this is the least I can do for Indonesia. Thank you.
Wow. Saya juga punya standar yang baru, kali ini boleh dinaikin lagi sedikit mic-nya. Saya punya standar lagi yang baru. Jadi mulai besok Senin, Sofia, Nadia, sama Bella akan masuk ke training. Trainingnya saya untuk pembentukan badan, saya di fully support sama Master Deddy Corbuzier. Jadi dia langsung yang akan menjadi head coach trainer buat ketiga queen saya. Karena target saya ketiganya punya six pack. I want that. Jadi badannya harus six pack. Kalau national directornya one pack. Zero pack. Jadi seperti itu. Lalu yang baru adalah mereka ada kelas nari. Jadi saya meng-hire satu seniman terbaik dari Ubud. Jadi dalam satu minggu, ketiga queen saya akan practicing traditional dance. Why? I believe. Tarian tradisional itu bisa menambah kesabaran. Melatih kesabaran, melatih emosi mereka, dan ada kejutan sedikit nanti untuk national costume-nya Sophie. I can tell that she
have to dance.
Wow.
She have to dance. Karena saya melihat bahwa national costume berat-berat nggak berpengaruh. Pakai efek kejut, ntar kebuka, ntar meledak, ntar keluar asap. Pusing pala gue. Pusing pala gue.
Accident.
Ya, jadi saya terus terang sebagai national director, aku mau ya kita di yayasan ini banyak belajar ya. Oke, jadi ini kita cerita sedikit tentang national costume ya. Kalau aku pribadi mempelajari bahwa national costume itu sepertinya yang akan kita bawa, aku nggak mau sesuatu yang berat, sesuatu yang heavy, tapi aku mau ada Queen itu dia bisa melakukan sesuatu di atas panggung. Jadi benar-benar all out. Dan I was thinking, karena Sophie tinggal di Bali, dia stay di Bali, aku mau national costume itu sesuatu yang berbau Bali. So, she have to learn how to dance Balinese.
Wow! I'm very excited about it actually.
Yeah. Jadi can you imagine perwakilan Indonesia, bule, tapi she's respect about culture. Can you tell us about pengalaman kamu di Bali with all the culture?
Sure. So actually, one of my best friends, I met her in, I lived in China before. She's one of my best friends, her name is Kesha, and she's Balinese. And her mom is like my second mom. She's very close with my mom, and they're all Balinese. So when Kesha visits me in Bali, I always try my best to like submerge myself in Balinese culture because I love Bali so much, like so much. It's my number one home in the world, you know. And I am totally a sucker for nature. I feel at home. I feel at peace. So yeah, with Kesha, we would go to Pura Tirta temple, and they would teach me about how to pray there, even if it's religious or not, you know? Because I believe that whether religion is a part of culture or not, it should be respected, you know? So yeah, I always would take part in things like that. And I always saw like kecak dance and Balinese dance.
Can you show me kecak dance like what?
Cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha. Yeah, it's like that. I'm obviously a pro. Yeah, so yeah, kecak dance. And one of my favorite spots in Bali was Uluwatu, and Uluwatu and Ubud are so rich with culture, you know? It's not like Kuta or anything like that. It's just so true to Indonesia and untouched Bali, you know? And that was my favorite part of living there. And I can't wait to go back.
Okay. Go back where? Go back where? Go back where, what do you mean? You can go anywhere. Saya mau di atas panggung, nanti Sophie akan bertanggung jawab. She have to responsibility ya. Dia punya responsibility di atas panggung. She's gonna be dance Bali properly. So that's why dia akan ada coaching Bali. Latihan nari itu coachingnya setiap hari Selasa sama hari Kamis. Jadi seminggu dua kali. Seminggu tiga kali, setiap pagi gym. Gym mix with yoga and other things.
Pilates.
Yeah, Pilates. Yes. Ya. Yeah. Oke. Okay. Untuk catwalk coaching akan ada beberapa coach dari luar Indonesia yang akan saya tinggalkan di Roseville Soho and Suites. Jadi untuk kemarin Aura punya authentic walk, ya. Yeah? And I believe Sophia akan punya authentic walk. Bella punya authentic walk. Sebenarnya Bella sudah punya authentic walk, tapi kan memang belum di share. Nadia pun demikian. Jadi saya pengalaman sama Aura ya. Kalau kita memberikan pelatihan mepet, anak ini akan muntah nanti di atas panggung. Tapi seperti apa yang Aura lakukan kemarin di Bangkok, itu adalah hasil trainingan berbulan-bulan yang diserap. Jadi masing-masing queen saya harus punya buku panduan. Bukunya apa? Apa yang akan kamu lakukan di sana? Semuanya tertulis di sini. Catwalk. There's many kind of walk. Depends on mau catwalk di mana. Even mau catwalk lagi ke kantor kantor pariwisata atau mau promo, itu ada catwalknya juga. Bagaimana jalan atau di interview media, di apa segala macam, itu semua ada di buku. Jadi semuanya itu tertulis. Kalau misalnya semuanya serba mendadak, mendadak ganti guru, jadi akhirnya mereka akan buyar. Kurang lebih seperti itu. Jadi nanti akan ada pelatih dari luar Indonesia, yang pastinya dia juga harus karantina 5 hari, dan akan saya karantina di Indonesia, nggak saya pulangin ke negaranya dulu. Jadi seperti itu. Uce?
Okay.
Ada lagi? Okay, please.
Hai! Jadi yang mau aku tanya, Kak,